everybody. Today I'm in Hackensack, New Jersey. I'm with Andy Geiger with Bergen Brookside Auto. And it is the middle of summer, and I didn't know it got as hot and humid in New Jersey as it does in Houston. But we're going to take a tour, learn a little bit about what you do here at Bergen, or Brookside, as most people call it. And Brookside is the first authorized Fraser service center that we have. We've had a wonderful relationship with them. Just thought we'd take you on a tour and learn a little bit about it. So let's go. So how long has Brookside been around?
Under the way we are now, 30 years.
30 years?
Almost 30 years, yeah.
So you're a millennial.
Yes, I've been here since 92, so it's 24 years now.
And how long have you been servicing EMS type vehicles?
At least 20 of those, if not longer.
How'd that all get started?
It was one of our accounts. We've worked on a bunch of our nurses' cars. They liked what we did, so they brought us a paramedic truck. They liked that, and then they started bringing us ambulances. And then since EMTs and paramedics all talked to each other, it became word of mouth, and one after the other started coming through the door.
And it seems like you have some areas that are more dedicated on the EMS side.
Yeah, this side is
the entire area. Yeah.
This side is more dedicated towards our fleet service, which is mostly EMS. Mm-hmm. We do a little bit of fire, a couple of fire trucks here and there, some regular accounts, but mostly EMS.
So how do people end up, if a hospital calls and they need service from you, how do you prioritize, hey, it's an ambulance and we need it back really soon?
We prioritize any ambulance that's in service as primary. So the crews will come down, whether it's ambulance, paramedic, if they're in service, we'll drop whatever we're working on for the rest of their fleet, and we'll go right to them and check it out. A lot of things we can fix right on the spot or within an hour, which they like.
Okay. And what all are you doing? I mean, are you doing everything from changing oil to collision?
Yes. We'll do anything they want.
Okay.
We've upgraded compartments. We've redesigned cabinets for them.
Oh, wow. Well, and you helped us put, we had a CT scanner delivered to Bergen. And we all got that thing in there together, so that was a fun one.
Yeah.
Well, let's walk us through and show us kind of all the cool things.
Yeah, the body shop, as you'll hear the noise in the background.
Right.
They're actually installing a new spray booth.
How often do ambulances get in little oops that you need to do body repair to those?
Monthly? Yeah. There's actually one here for one of the hospitals.
Oh, really? Yeah, I mean, the reality is moving a vehicle around like that, they're gonna...
And most of the time, it's not because they were on their way to a call. Most of the times, they're sitting still when they get hit.
or I've seen a few that back into the post at the station.
Yeah, that's just normal. Most of the time, we just straighten the bumpers out for them. They don't even bother with that.
Right.
Most of the ones we've had lately, they'll be sitting at a traffic light. They'll be driving down the street, and for some oddball reason, they're big accident magnets.
Yeah,
we don't know why. They just get hit.
So how large is, I mean, I've walked your facility. This is a great facility. How large is it?
This building is a little over 10,000 square feet, same as that one. Mm-hmm. We have another facility two blocks down that we use for our towing trucks.
Okay.
We have one up the street that we also use for our bigger stuff.
So tell me a little bit how the relationship started with Fraser. I mean, I know that you were recommended to us from Hackensack Volunteer. They were just thrilled with the job that you guys did. And so we started that quite some time ago.
Yeah. And then Hackensack, the hospital, bought a bunch of trucks and they wanted us to repair them, which you guys agreed to. And Valley, same thing.
Right, absolutely.
And then one after the other.
So what types of issues do you tend to see on our units? I don't see any of them right now.
No,
I was going to love to show one,
but
we don't have one, so that must be a good sign.
Yeah, they're hardly ever here.
You do mainly what, the maintenance on them?
The maintenance and the generator services.
It is hot here, so what do you know about our air conditioning?
Well, your air conditioning,
I mean, it takes a licking.
Yeah.
That's for
sure. Oh, yeah,
sure.
That it does. We never had a problem with them.
Yeah.
The crews love them because it's always cold in the back of their truck.
That's right, yeah, and it's here we are kind of sweating. I'm not sweating, by the way. I'm glowing, just in case anybody's wondering.
Yeah, they never have an issue with your air conditioning. Everybody else's air conditioning, it's too hot. There's no heat. The patient's complaining. The paramedics are complaining, but they get in the
Survey
Frasers.
Says, give us Fraser AC.
Yeah.
We love that.
We have our prep area where they do a lot of the pre-painting.
Uh-huh.
Like, actually, this is for a Ford van, probably an ambulance.
And did you know, well, this is probably not a big surprise to you, but 75% of all accidents occur in the front quarter panel.
Yep.
Which you know
oh,
all
yeah.
the time.
Oh,
you
we know that well. Yeah, we just keep going. Here's our paint room.
Oh, nice mixing station.
Yes.
I like
So they do all the mixing, do all the prep work, tape off the car, put in the booth, spray away.
Andy, thank you so much. It was a great tour.
Well, thank you.
Y'all have got an amazing facility here, and we're just looking to continuing our long relationship.
Yes, so are we.
Don't forget to visit us at www.fraserbilt.com and like us on Facebook, and hopefully next time we'll have a little bit cooler weather.